Welcome to an example of an improper integral, where the interval of integration is an infinite interval. And in this case, notice how the lower limit of integration is negative infinity, and the upper limit of integration is positive infinity. So for a quick review, we'd be looking at case 3 of infinite intervals, again, because the lower limit of integration is negative infinity, and the upper limit of integration is positive infinity. So what we're going to do is write this as two separate integrals where we select a constant c in the interval and write the first integral as the integral from negative infinity to c, and the second integral is from c to positive infinity. Once we have these two separate integrals, we'll then write these using limit notation as we see here above. So going back to our example, let's use the constant 0 to break this up into two separate integrals. We'll write this as the integral from negative infinity to 0 plus the integral from 0 to positive infinity. And now we're going to write each of these integrals using limits. So we'll write this first integral as the limit as, let's say, a approaches negative infinity. So notice how we're going to replace negative infinity with a. So we'll have the integral from a to 0 plus, let's use the limit as b approaches positive infinity. So now we're substituting b for infinity. So we'll have the integral from 0 to b. And now we'll integrate, then determine the limits. So we'll have the limit as a approaches negative infinity. When we integrate here, we'll have negative 3 times x to the fifth divided by 5, or just negative 3 fifths x to the fifth. The limits of integration are from a to 0, and then plus the limit as b approaches infinity of negative 3 fifths x to the fifth from 0 to b. So we'll have the limit as a approaches negative infinity. First we'll substitute 0, which would just be 0, minus negative 3 fifths a to the fifth, plus the limit as b approaches infinity. First x is b, so we'll have negative 3 fifths b to the fifth, minus when x is 0, we just have 0. And now we'll evaluate the limits. Here we have minus a negative, which should become plus a positive. And then a is approaching negative infinity, but it's raised to the fifth power, so it remains negative. And therefore, this first limit is approaching negative infinity, plus as b approaches positive infinity, we have negative 3 fifths times a value approaching positive infinity raised to the fifth, which is still positive. A negative times a positive is negative, so the second limit is also approaching negative infinity, which means these limits don't exist, and therefore we can say the definite integral diverges and approaches negative infinity. If we take a look at the graph f of x equals negative 3x to the fourth, notice how the function is always less than or equal to 0, and therefore, if we shaded the region bounded by the function on the x-axis, it would look like this, and notice how this area is unbounded, and also because the area is below the x-axis, this is the reason why the definite integral diverges and approaches negative infinity. Remember, it's only when the function is non-negative that the definite integral represents the area bounded by the function and the x-axis. I hope you found this explanation helpful.